very cost-effective way and very useful way of preventing very grave and serious diseases.
Yes.
Like meningitis, mm-hmm. like polio, like pertussis, mm-hmm. like hepatitis, mm-hmm. which have been scavenging or killing people and children in millions throughout the world.
Yes, and over and great periods of time.
Yeah,
also.
It's not only the death or the mortality, the morbidity is very high. If a child gets meningitis, he may be handicapped. And 1/4 of the children who at a very young age will develop meningitis are likely to end up in some form of neurological deficit. They may go blind, they may go deaf, they may not be able to walk, they may be handicapped and so on and so forth. This is just one example to understand the benefits of vaccines.
Yes.
Similarly, there are other diseases like pertussis, what we call as whooping cough.
Yes.
Is a very high mortality rate, very high morbidity leads
to... But what is the difference between morbidity and mortality?
Well, for example, in meningitis, when you get meningitis, some children would lose their life. And we call this, this is the mortality of that disease. Sometimes they survive, but they have certain handicaps or certain lingering problems as final post-meningitic complications, what we call. That is the morbidity, that how many people fall sick and remain handicapped or remain diseased even after the spell of the disease is over.
Okay, so it's not a full recovery. So if you don't fully recover from it, then that's a morbidity.
Yeah, morbidity.
Interesting. And so Dr. Zafar, what goes... So Dr. Kazi mentioned that a vaccine has basically like a denatured virus or a sort of less vicious virus. So what else goes in... So basically what you're...